So I promise if I had anything on this that has been said before, I'm not going to say it, except for thank you, which I am going to say even though people have said. But I am grateful to you, Rep. McEntee, and to you, Chairman Craven, and to all our legislative and administrative supporters. And I am the most thankful to these incredible families who now have walked out, but we'll tell them that I told them, who have had the courage to come here year after year and share their typically private and, as you've heard, often very painful stories for the purposes of this advocacy. So they are amazing. So I think we're all in agreement. Let's make this the last hearing where we drag them out into the dark of night to share their darkest days. This is the year. And so I'm literally looking down for everything that I'm not going to say that's been said before. But as you heard tonight, many couples, including my husband and myself, turn to assisted reproduction to build their family. And one in six couples go through infertility, so chances are most of us know people who have built their family in this maybe non-traditional way. I think fewer of us know people who have used surrogacy, so I just wanted to share a brief story to just illustrate the many different families that turn to surrogacy to build their family, and they absolutely, none of them take it lightly because it's definitely a complex process. So my favorite part of my job, oh, I meant to say that I'm the executive director of Resolve New England, which is a nonprofit that provides support, education, and advocacy to anyone in New England that's struggling to make their dream of parenthood come true. And my favorite part of my job is getting to know the amazing individuals and couples that have to go through so much just to become parents, which many of us take for granted. So one of those couples that I was privileged to know, their names are Lori and Ryan. They're both military veterans, and they were in their 20s and had just gotten engaged, which should have been the happiest time, one of the happiest times of their life. However, soon after their engagement, Lori was diagnosed with an aggressive form of ovarian cancer. She was nearly as upset about the fact that she might not be a parent as she was about the cancer. And that might sound a little bit strange to people, but then again, if your parents yourselves think about how important that is to your life, and she thought that might not happen for them. She actually told Ryan that it wasn't too late if he wanted to marry someone else that could be a parent with him. Needless to say, Ryan did not need to be already married to have the vow of sickness and in health, and did not leave her side. She needed a full hysterectomy and thankfully was cured of her cancer. So without a uterus, she could not carry a pregnancy, but with IVF and a gestational carrier, they were able to have a baby. And so they couldn't be here, but I just brought a picture of them. This is them.
Oh, nice.
And they're incredible in every way. And I think this just illustrates the diversity of families and how they're built that exists today. And also, as people have been saying, that it's not about genetics. Parenthood is about so much more than that. And this, an updated parentage law with the amendments that we've discussed tonight, will provide the equality and security for all families in Rhode Island. And we want a law this year, and we want a law that's based on best practice that we can all be proud of. So I really feel that this is the year thing, and hopefully I did not repeat too much. So thank you very much.
Kate, I'd like to say something.
Yeah.
The testimony that I've heard this year and last year has been very compelling to many of us who the subject matter is new to us. Is it more or less, I hate to use the word, non-traditional way of having a child?
Right.
And you can tell the love and also the concern or the fears from those that testify. But let me just tell you a little bit about the political reality of this. And this is good news. This is the kind of news that you should put your head down on the pillow tonight and say, I think we're going to get it this year.
Oh, I like that type.
The sponsors, in the business of politics, when you have the speaker, the majority leader, and the committee chairman, and you've got
and the vice chair,
the assassin here, who is gonna kill everybody in the way. You can't lose.
That's
so
great.
I want you to know that those fears, I understand them. You know, that's a natural human reaction, but this is going to be a good year for you guys.
That's great. Thank you. And we just want to work together to have the best bill possible. Yeah.
Yep.
And
we will.
to bring all the expertise that we're fortunate to have. The good thing, I've said that, I think I said this last year, sometimes states want to be first with a bill. That's always exciting to be first, and it's a badge of honor. But sometimes I think it's great to be sixth, because you learn from the five before you, and we have that opportunity here in Rhode Island. So our bill can be excellent, even better than the other states. So we like some healthy competition.
But it's been a pleasure to get to know this issue and get to know the people that
Well, the people are amazing. I mean,
they are.
We are blessed to be part of this coalition. So thank you.
So thank you
from
the members of the committee.
Thank you.